Yes.
Okay, sister, most welcome.
Okay, my name is Femi. I'm Christian. My as in Al-Quran, surat 43, As-Sukruf 61. Sebentar.
Sister, I thought you knew English.
Wait.
There is no satu in English.
Okay.
Can you ask in
English? Can I read surat 43 As-Sukruf 61?
Can you just repeat which surah is it?
In English.
Which surah is it?
43 As-Sukruf.
Al-Zukhruf number 43, correct? Verse number?
61.
Okay, go ahead.
Wa innahu la ilmu li sa'ati fala tamtaruna biha wa tabiun haza ziratun mustaqim. And Al-Fatihah. Al-Fatihah number 6. Ihdinas siratal mustaqim. Yes, my ask is, who is mean of one way?
What is the meaning of Sirat al-Mustaqim?
What is the meaning of Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim?
Yeah, As-Sirat al-Mustaqim.
As-Sirat al-Mustaqim.
The path.
The sister first quoted Surah Zukhruf, chapter 43, verse number 61, which says that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, will be the sign of the coming of the hour before the day of judgment. And we believe, the Muslims believe, that Isa alayhi salam will come before the day of judgment. That is the reason I quoted and translated earlier in Surah Nisa chapter 4, 158, that Allah raised him up alive. So the Quran says in Surah Zukhruf, chapter 43, verse 61, that Isa alayhi salam will be the sign for the hour, for the day of judgment. We believe in it. Your question was, what is Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim? We are quoting Surah Fatiha, chapter number 1, verse number 5 and 6.
Yes.
That show us the straight path. What is the Sirat al-Mustaqim?
Yeah.
This Quran is the Sirat al-Mustaqim.
Oh, yeah.
Surah Fatiha is called as Ummul Qurah, mother of the Quran, and it is, first we pray to Allah, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm Ad-Deen, the Lord of all the worlds, praise be to Him, the Lord of all the worlds, the merciful, the gracious, master of the day of judgment, Thee alone we worship, Thee alone we ask for. Show us the straight path. Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. The path of those who have earned and favor, and not the path of those who go astray. And then all the surahs of the Quran, from surah number 2, from Surah Baqarah to Surah Nas, surah number 114, is the path for guidance. This full Quran is Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. The Sirat al-Mustaqim is the glorious Quran. Sister, do you want to follow the straight path?
Of course, I want to follow one way.
Do you want to follow one way?
Yes.
Sister, do you believe there is one God?
Of course.
Do you believe that Jesus is God, or do you believe Jesus is a messenger of God?
I think Jesus is a messenger.
MashaAllah. Sister, do you believe that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the messenger of God?
Yes, I believe.
Sister, the minimum two requirements for anyone to be a Muslim, to say that he has enrolled as a Muslim, is believe that there is one God, believe that Jesus is not God but messenger, and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God. So according to me, you are already a Muslim, sister.
Yes, the reason I believe Jesus is messenger, in the Bible tell Johannes, Judas 30, 14, Ayat 6.
Jesus said to him, 14 verse 6, yes.
Yes. Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
No one comes to the Father
except through me. So, Jesus is a messenger from Allah.
You are perfectly right, sister. Most of the Christians, they misunderstand that this verse of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, because of this verse, he is claiming to be God. Your understanding of Bible is perfectly correct. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. If you read the context, to understand this verse, the context is, you have to go to verse number 1, Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 1, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, if your heart is troubled, and if you believe in God, believe in me also. For in my Father's house, there are many mansions. I am going there to prepare a place for you. And when I go, I will show you the way. Then Philip asked me, which way do you go? Then he says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto my Father but through me. This means every messenger at his time, he was the way, the truth, and the life. No man came unto Almighty God but through the messenger. And your understanding is perfectly right. But today, the last and final messenger is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to Almighty God but through by the teaching of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Who says that? Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said that. If you read ahead, Gospel of John, chapter number 16, verse number 12 to 14, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, I have many things to say unto you, but he cannot bear them now. For he, when the Spirit of truth shall come, he shall guide you unto all truth. He shall not speak of himself. All that he shall speak, he shall glorify me. Yet Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is prophesying the final and last messenger to come, talking about Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So your understanding of the Bible is very clear and correct, that Jesus is a messenger of God, and the last and final messenger of God is Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So according to me, sister, you are a Muslim. Sister, according to me, you are a Muslim.
Yes.
Would you like to say it in Arabic? Would you like to say it in Arabic?
Go ahead. Yes. I want.
I'll say it in Arabic. Wait, and you can repeat it, inshallah.
I just want to tell for people in here.
Okay, I'll say it in Arabic and you can repeat it.
Yeah, I think Al-Quran is the truth, because Al-Quran tell all about messenger and about Jesus, especially in the true word.
MashaAllah, yeah. You're perfectly right, sister.
So I believe in Jesus, and I believe Muhammad. I believe just one God is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
MashaAllah. I will say it in Arabic and you can repeat it, sister. Ashadu.
Okay. Ashadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashadu.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Abduhu.
Wa rasuluhu.
Takbir. Takbir.
Allah Akbar. I bear witness.
That
there is no God
but Allah
and Prophet Muhammad
is the messenger
and servant
of Allah.
MashaAllah. May Allah grant you Jannah. Sister, the moment a person accepts Islam, all his previous sins are gained. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may he grant you Jannah. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Amen.
That through you, may he guide the other people to the truth. And I request the Muslims of Indonesia, whenever a person accepts Islam, you have to love him, You have to care for him or her and try and see to it that they feel comfortable.